Thank you. Thank you very much. Today's show is of such gargantuan proportions, it cannot be contained within the edifice of the library. So we will adjourn forthwith to the area adjoining the library, just outside. And it's what we call a bullwhip, was the name of this one. Now you hear it makes a popping sound, but it's not any kind of like firecrackers or anything. What it is, it's very fascinating. I'll tell you how the bullwhip or any other kind of whip cracks. You notice that it's thick here and then tapers down like this, okay? Now, if I swing it around like this, like nothing happens, okay? But when we put like a little bend, it makes a crack. And the way it does that, it's very fascinating. What happens is when it goes like this, it goes faster and faster and faster until it gets to the point and it goes so fast, it actually makes a minor sonic boom. It actually breaks the sound barrier. And it is able to do that. They call the principle in physics is the conservation of angular momentum. So you can tell everybody that you learned about the conservation of angular momentum. And it's like in a roller coaster, you know, and you go into a tight turn and zing, you come flying out. Or when you drive and the freeway thing gets tighter, zing, and you know how it feels? Because it makes you go faster when the angle is reduced. Or as we say, conserved. Now, anyway, about the whips, that was very fascinating, wasn't it? Oh, that's why I did it first. There we go. Thank you. Now, these whips, what they would do, and now people think that they would hit the cows and stuff. When they don't hit the cows, they would manage to herd them just with the sound because they can crack it like right near where the cow is, and then they go, you know, off in the opposite direction. And it's the same thing in like circuses. People see, you know, like in the lion acts and they crack and what have you, but they don't hit them. And they actually have a name for people that actually would hit the big cat with the whip. They call them lunch, because if they, that's true, now that's true. That's what they call them, because if they hit one of those big cats, oh, the cat get mad and eat them. But with the sound though, they're able to like direct them. So, you know, and then they also use them, like they'll swing them above like this and the cat, we'll reach up and then it looks like it's standing on its legs. So, you know, that's how they use them. But now over the years, of course, they stopped doing, you know, so much work, like cowboys, you know, aren't like herding cows anymore and stuff like that. But what happened even then was these guys would start, you know, practicing with their whips, you know, and thinking, oh boy, you know, I can do different things. Like for example, fancy cracking actually has somewhat of a purpose. There's one, just like that, one back, one up, one down, and if you crack it just like that, but it starts your horse going, gives the cows a little jump, and then makes them go faster. Now they also do that same type of thing, like this, which actually I like better for that, but this goes down, around, and down. So you can't see it very fast, but anyway, that's that. Now this also, this is just like in an S, goes in an S and down. But it makes one crack here, one crack here, see? So if I have things I want to drive somewhere here, then we crack like that. Now also, because the tip of this goes so fast, it imparts a great deal of energy, can impart a great deal of force. So that's why if this part hits, then it hurts, I tell you. But I'm gonna show you a little stunt with a whip. Now this is a little piece of styrofoam, but you can use them for targets. With a whip. There we go. Thank you. There we are. Now let me get out another kind of whip. Thank you very much. Now actually this one, like I said, is made real good. This is made by a friend of mine. His name was Leonard Wheatley. And it just made it so great. I actually have another one. But I'm going to show you a different style of whip that was also made by my friend Leonard Wheatley. This one they call a snake whip. Now this one is flexible throughout. Like this one has like a solid handle there, but the snake whip, it's like flexible throughout the whole thing. And this was primarily designed so that the cowboys could roll it up and put it in their saddlebag. And I had my friend Leonard make it for me a long time ago because I wanted to do a trick where I wrap it around myself. Now, is this going to bug the mic if I wrap the whip around myself? Okay. I don't want to bug the mic. It's kind of a technical term. But I wanted a whip I could just go like this, and even though it's relatively short, I could wrap it around myself like this. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Now, the way that why this doesn't hurt is because I crack it. It actually cracks there. But you can't see it. It goes bingo right there, and then just wraps around very easy. Now, tell you what, why don't we? We'll use this one for a trick, too. There we go. I'll try this one behind the back. There we go. Thank you. Thank you very much. There we go. There we go. I'm going to put my whips right here. Because I didn't put any sunscreen on them. I don't want them getting in the end tonight. Now, I'll tell you what, I was kidding. But actually, leaving them in the sun is not a good idea. Now, this one is still, it's a different kind of whip. Now, they call this a stock whip. And in like the little pictures like that they put up on the wall, it shows like a guy, and it's more like a stock whip. And see, this one has like a longer handle, but then the whip part of it is kind of separate and joined on separately. So they call it a stock whip. Now, these are very, very popular in Australia. For some reason, they caught on more in Australia than they did here, although in the old days, especially they'll have these guys they called the bullwhackers. Bullwhackers. And what they did was they would walk alongside these covered wagons that were drawn by oxes, or, you know, bulls, but they call them, you know, bulls with like oxen. And these guys would just walk along all day and like, hey, bang, and try and, you know, keep them going. Now, again, they didn't hit them because that would make them like stampede and, you know, there goes, you know, your covered wagon, destroy the whole, you know, wagon train, as they used to call them. But now this. So what I'm doing is going front and back. It's mainly just like a flourish. But like I was saying, that's how the kind of the evolution of whips, you know, as far as their use went from being used for driving cattle to just like being used for, you know, showmanship. Sit, whip, stay. Now I've got some more. I got a couple more. Let's see. Here we are. I've actually got a matched pair of Australian stock whips. Now these, you know, these are different color. They're actually a different tanning process, and that's why they aren't the same as the other ones. Now these are all cowhide whips. Then later on I'll show you a different one. Thank you. There we go. There we go. Now, I promised you I would show you one made from kangaroo hide. A kangaroo hide. And oddly enough, here it is. Now, if you guys go see that movie about Catwoman, you know, I think she used a kangaroo hide whip. She used a bull whip, but the handle isn't as long. This has kind of a long handle for a bullet, but it's still, you know, continuously out from it. Also, this one has a flexible handle, like graphite or something. I'm actually not sure what's in it. Now, one of the things Catwoman would do in the last film, anyway, she'd wrap it around herself and then make it come out again like this. See? She wrapped it around. Now, actually, that maneuver was invented by another whip artist friend of mine. His name is Brian Chick. Brian Chick invented that, then everybody else started picking up on it, and then started doing Brian's maneuver of cracking it, making it go around, and then cracking it back out. Okay, now I'm going to do another little trick then. Why not? We'll do a trick with this whip. Let's see. I put one in front. I put one in back. I tell you what we'll do. I'll try one. Off the top of my head. May as well. Here we go. Thank you. I'll have to go and pick those up later on. Now I notice I'm kind of hitting things there. Oh, you guys want to see another fun trick? Tell you what, I'm going to use this little handkerchief. I'll try this. But the wind's kind of blowing it, but I'm going to try anyway. I'll put it in my back pocket. And I'm going to try and get it out with the whip. Let's see. There we go. Thank you. Thank you very much. Whee! There we go. I'll put this one in my mouth. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Let's see. Now, tell you what I'm going to do. Now, the next one, let me put this here. I'm going to finish up this segment here, and then I'll open it up for questions and answers. Anybody has any questions, I'll try to answer them. But for my last little trick, I'm going to hold one in my mouth, put the other one on top of my head, then I'm going to crack them out with three cracks. One there, one wind up, bingo, and one, hopefully, cracking it out. Thank you. There we go. Now, yesterday when I was practicing this, oh, did I hit my nose? Which is why Cyrano de Bergerac used a sword instead of a whip. There's a story about a guy with a big nose named Cyrano de Bergerac. You've got to check it out. It's right there on the shelf. There's also a couple movies you can watch. But anyway, which are also available here at the library. But anyway, I promised you the stunt, so here we go. May I have a drum roll, please? There we go. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I started fooling around with the whips when I was a young kid, and I started fooling around with them on my own, and I learned some. And then I started going to this guy's house, Leonard Wheatley, and then he helped me to learn stuff. And then I also got videotapes from a place called the Wild West Arts Club. I just practiced on my own. And you know, some of it, like I was saying, is kind of painful practice, but that's how I got started. How many shows have I been doing with the whips? Well, I've done, I haven't kept count, but I've done some very fascinating ones. Including, I do some whip stunts on a TV show, it's on HBO called Carnival. But mainly I do sword throwing on that, but I have done some whip segments, also some knife throwing. And then I also did some shows at like Cabrillo School and stuff like that. But the actual number is so great that no one can even count that high, even I, who can count up to five. Can you make a living by doing it? Only if you have mastered the art of not eating, which I have done. Now, in fact, you know what? I'm gonna come out with a new thing called the Whip Artist Diet, where you make your living solely from being a whip artist, and then that way, yeah, it ends up, you kinda get nice and slim. More now in motion pictures. Also, I perform in Las Vegas as well, so I kinda spread it out, you know, here and then in Nevada also. That's it. There are no more questions. I have answered all questions. Thank you. Now don't forget.